So, what did Lauren see? It's all coming out in the EastEnders Omnibus in an hour's time. Right now on BBC One Scotland, things are changing in Shieldinch.
I sometimes wonder if I'm in a rut.
We're selling up here. Fresh start for us both.
They are selling the pub.
I don't believe it.
What did you say about Raymond was saying to you? About you finding a new vacation? It's a sign.
The tall ship is up for sale.
Ewan, I think I'm pregnant. Go say something.
Congratulations.
It's his birthday today.
Who?
The boy with no name.
All right. I'll find him.
Really?
I'll try.
Jimmy, this is meant to be. I know it. You could be the landlord for the tall ship.
Give me a look.
What?
I want to see it.
You saw it at the bank.
Raymond, come on.
Breathe. Right. Not bad, eh?
Suppose.
Suppose? There's 30 grand in there.
I know, but if we'd sold the place.
I didn't want to sell it, did I? Anyway, how much more money do we need?
What's 30 grand get you nowadays anyway? A new car?
What kind of car are you after?
You know what I mean.
Hey, it's plenty. Besides, it's not about the money, is it? About me and you being together.
You're right.
Anyway, you know what Spain's like. Full of wealthy expats. Bet I could get you a nice wee cleaning job.
So, you feeling better?
Yeah.
No more sickness?
No more sickness? Right, look after your brother for 2 minutes. It's probably just as well, really, you know. Well, since Heather's gone. She was so good at looking after me and the kids. Feels weird, just us in the flat, you know? You sure you even think
Joe, about... I'm not moving into Heather's.
Think how much better you get to know the boys.
Just because we're having a baby.
But Ewan, please,
look,
I don't...
How long are you going to be in town for?
About an hour.
Right then.
Right.
I see my accountant will go see you.
Yeah? Is he cute? Right, regular or whole grain?
Whatever.
You know that computer game thing?
What about it?
Yeah, well, you could teach me how to play it.
I thought you hated that kind of stuff.
Yeah, well, I hated you too, didn't I? Till I got to know you.
Well, we'd need a couple of hours at least.
Right, okay, well, why don't you finish off here? I'll get the wee one home. By the time you get back, she'll be fast asleep.
What are the chances?
Oh, she's exhausted. She hardly slept last night.
I noticed. Fine. It's worth a try.
Right, okay, cool. Right, nappies, one pack or two.
The amount she goes through, I'd get a dozen.
Shoot, shoot! Oh, almost, almost! That's
it. Oh, that's it, that's it! Oh, get in there!
Oh, high five!
You're playing football in the gutter. Really, Lenny, what kind of example's that setting the kids?
You're just whining because you're always left odd in the jackets.
Damn.
Where is it?
That's a euro up again. See, if we just changed the money yesterday, we'd have got a whole lot more.
Would you stop worrying about the money?
Maybe we should just take the rest of the cash out.
No way.
But what is the point in having 2 grand just sitting there in your account?
It's a safety net, an emergency fund.
It doesn't mean we'd have to spend it.
If we take it out, we'd spend it. You know we would.
Raymond.
No. Absolutely not.
No. Absolutely not. Right, I'm just going to go and hide this.
No, you won't. I'm locking it in the safe.
Oh, that's a much better idea.
You coming?
Actually, no.
What's going on?
It's a surprise. Go on, there you go.
I'm going.
Sharon McLaren.
Well, I must say this is unexpected. So, how are things?
Oh, you know.
How much?
Sorry?
How much do you need?
Am I really that transparent?
15 pounds, that's all I have.
Things haven't been easy these past few weeks. Just trying to make ends meet, you know? I didn't want to bother you. Too proud, maybe? So I borrowed some money off a guy I know. Former client. Known him for years. I actually thought he was a friend.
And what happened?
Missed a payment. Not a problem. I mean, well, at least I didn't think it was a problem. Just cash flow. Told him I'd pay him next week, but turns out it is a problem. A big problem.
He hasn't threatened you, has he? Oh. So, how much?
£300, and he wants it this afternoon.
£300? I don't have that kind of money, Hutch.
This is serious, Mother. It's very serious. Look, I know I haven't always been the best of sons to you, but when the chips were down, I was always there for you. That's surely got to count for something.
Malcolm and I were planning a holiday, a little cruise, perhaps, in the spring. And he's been saving. There's £240, yeah.
Thanks. And the,
Oh, yes, of course, right.
Thanks, Mother. I'll pay you back as soon as I can. I better get going.
I didn't have to say, Miss Kemp. I just got you the ordinary stuff.
Archie. Malcolm. No, I was just on my way out, sir.
All right.
See ya.
You were saying about the milk.
A good goalie.
Are you all right? Do you need to sit down?
No, I'm fine.
What did you do that for, idiot?
Ewan, I said I'm fine.
No, you really could have hurt her. What the hell do you think you're playing at?
Calm down.
You heard her. She's fine.
Ewan, please.
She's no hot.
She's pregnant.
How many weeks? Not long.
I'm going to call the doctor.
I don't need a doctor. We should take her to the surgery.
No, look, I just want to get out of here.
Right, you heard the girl. Ewan, go and get the car. Will you get the kids' stuff together? You're coming home with us. Come on, let's go.
Let me get this right. You don't know who he owes it to, what the guy's threatening with, or when he plans to pay us back? My savings, Liz. Every last penny.
Look, he's my son.
I know he is. I know he is, and I know what he is. That was for our holiday. Our first proper holiday.
Yes, I know.
You're an intelligent woman, Liz. How often does he have to let you down?
He just seemed so...
Aye, well, he's no fool right enough. He knows what buttons to press.
Look, I'll talk to him. I'll get it back.
Aye, and what's he going to say? There you go, Mother. Thanks ever so much. The boy's a liar, Liz. A cheat and a liar.
Stop it.
That money's gone. It's gone for good.
Look, I said stop it. Maybe he did lie. Maybe I am being foolish, but I've said I'll get it back, and I will.
I've started to run the bath upstairs. You know, I'll take care of the little ones. You can relax.
Thanks, Lydia. You've been really kind.
Why didn't you say something? I mean, a child, Ewan. You've only just started seeing each other. What's her mum got to say about it?
She hasn't told her. She hasn't told anyone.
Why not?
Know something about the first 3 months.
Well, I'm glad you're taking such an active interest. Seriously, though, have you even begun to think this through? I mean, she's got a lot on her plate. Are you sure this is what you want?
What I want? You're the one that practically invited her to move in.
Don't over-exaggerate, Ewan. She's having a baby. Your baby. It's time for you to step up.
How's she doing?
Yeah, she's fine.
Good, right. I'm going to go out on a wee errand, okay? I'm going to take this wee fella with me. Eh? Never too young to start learning the business.
Is it?
Oh. Hey. And we're off.
Is it not a bit?
What?
Not really my kind of thing.
Aye, well, it's not for you. It's for Raymond.
What will I put?
I don't know. A wee message. What will you remember most about him?
He's not very tall.
Something positive.
He's taller than you.
Well, that's brilliant. Raymond's gone abroad, maybe for the rest of his life, and you're standing there cracking jokes. What if it was you going away? What would you want him to say?
I would leave my family to go swanning off abroad.
You're angry at him, aren't you?
What?
You're angry because he's leaving you.
He's a big boy. He can do what he likes.
Aye, well, I'm not talking about him. I'm talking about you. You're deflecting your sense of abandonment.
Have you been reading a book?
What if I have?
Yeah. I hope you've no brought me out here to take advantage of me. I'm a married man, you know.
You're safe enough.
What can I do for you?
I want to borrow some money.
Much?
50,000.
Uh-huh.
Oh, come on, you know we're good for it.
We?
Me and Raymond.
Oh, you both want to borrow it?
Yeah, that's right. Absolutely.
What's it for?
A business venture. Dead set.
Ain't he the best kind? What if the whole thing goes wrong?
It won't.
Humour me.
He still owns the pub.
What do you think? Should we give the lady the money? My associate's not convinced.
50% interest, right? I'll give you 60. Would a lollipop convince your associate?
What a lollipop? Take a while to work the papers out.
It's already done.
Is that right?
I'm in a hurry.
What if I say no?
I'll go somewhere else.
Give me an hour.
You'll do it.
What can I say? I'm a nice guy. Eh? Just in case you think they're pulling a fast one. Remember, there'll nobody the lawyers are saying round. See ya.
Hush, little baby, don't say a word. Papa's gonna buy you a mockingbird. That mocking bird won't sing. Papa's gonna buy you, sorry, diamond ring. If that diamond ring goes brass, Papa's gonna buy you a looking glass. And if that looking...
Maybe I should try her in the bedroom. She's just completely overtired.
It's fine. You're a single parent now. You gotta expect that kind of thing. Well, you are.
I made a commitment.
What about Ruth? Doesn't she have a commitment?
We've had this conversation.
Yeah, well, maybe it's time we had it again.
Look, Ruth needs me. They both need me.
Great. So while you're breaking your back, the kid's father, her real father, he's sitting with his feet up somewhere. He's blissfully unaware.
Never met Marty, did you? He doesn't really do blissful.
I don't care what he does. It's him who should be elbow deep in dirty nappies, not you. And I'll tell you something else. Have you ever considered that maybe he has a right to know?
Yes, of course.
Really? Because that is his child there. His flesh and blood. Who knows what kind of father he might be? He might be great. Best dad in the world. The point is, you don't know. You don't know what he'd be like.
I've got a fairly good idea.
Well, I don't think that's good enough.
Yeah, well, it's the way Ruth wants it, okay? It's what she decided.
I'm not sure it's just Ruth's decision to make. You're breaking up a home, keeping a kid away from its dad. I've been through that, Scott. I know what that's like.
I didn't realise.
Didn't realise I didn't ask.
I don't know what to say.
You don't have to say anything. I don't expect you to know everything about me. It's just since Ailey came along, you stopped asking. You stopped being interested in me, Scott.
Come on, that's not true. It's just... I never realised it would be like this, you know? That it would be this hard. But okay, give me half an hour, yeah? I'll get her off to sleep, and then we can have all afternoon together, okay? And we'll talk, I promise.
There you are. What are you up to?
Well, I was just double checking that all the cash was present and correct.
You like? Stop panicking. We've got plenty of money. I'll give it here before somebody spots it lying about. Oh, safe keys. Thank you.
Found it! Jimmy's always wanting to chuck stuff like this out. But I knew it'd come in handy. Donkey. Donkey be castanets in its lugs. Flamenco dancer. Maracas. Maybe this thing is a bit tacky.
No, it's fine.
What? I wonder why a donkey would have castanets hanging from his ear. Doesn't really make sense, does it?
You've got a point.
Mind you, if it's logic we're after, why am I wasting time on farewell drinks for a two-faced tart I can't wait to see the back of?
She's not that bad.
You've changed your tune.
Well, maybe I've just got to know her a bit better. Anyway, it's not what we think that matters, it's what Raymond thinks.
Raymond doesn't think. She's got him so tightly wrapped around her wee finger. Cut off the old.
Wow! What do you think?
Fabulous. We aim to please. Oh,
thank you so much for doing this. It really means a lot to him, you know? Come here.
Oh, Raymond. Insurance documents. And your autograph, please, here and here.
This is my surprise.
It might be.
Accidental injury.
Better safe than sorry. And hospital cover.
Can I go now?
One more. See? That wasn't so difficult, was it?
Right, well that's me, you, Malcolm, Liz, Gina, Ruth and Jimmy. I suppose we can just get the rest of them in the pub later on, eh?
Suppose.
Will you cheer up?
I'm fine.
Look, I realise you're a naturally miserable person. I'm used to it. But the day of oddies, can you not just make an effort?
Oh, I'm sorry. I didn't realise what a sacrifice it was having me around. Maybe I should just leave you to it, eh?
Beak! Good morning, your morning.
Ah, yeah. My phone's been out of juice.
Oh, right. I was just wondering if you wanted to grab a coffee or something.
Oh, aye. See, the thing is, I promised I'd help Bob out.
What?
You know that thing you have to do?
Oh, aye.
I mean, otherwise I would have loved to.
Okay then, right. I'll see you at the party later, innit?
Aye, great.
That was pathetic.
Look, just leave me alone, right?
Complete and utter lack of insight. That's your problem.
Insight?
Self-knowledge.
There's that book again.
You're upset because Raymond's leaving, but you're unwilling to acknowledge your emotions. You turn your anger inwards, and that is why
You're a miserable swine. Can give you a Lenny if you want.
No, you're all right.
Well, that was quick.
Oh, sounded urgent. So, what's the problem?
That money I lent you, it wasn't mine to lend.
Well, like I said, I'll pay it all back.
Have you got it on you?
No, I went straight to see this guy.
What's his name?
What does it matter what his name is?
Simple question.
What is going on here?
Did you lie to me?
No, I told you I borrowed some money. The guy got all heavy on me. Look, I've explained all this.
When are you going to pay it back?
When I have it.
When?
As soon as I can.
Okay. As soon as you can. But if you can't, like if something comes up, anything at all, don't bother telling me.
What do you mean?
You've made me feel foolish, Archie. Made me feel like a silly old woman. So the next time I see you, it'll be to get Malcolm's money back, all of it.
Okay. It might take me some time.
Oh, well, it might take some time before I see you again.
I'm not too early.
Are you on time? You want to count it?
I trust you.
Just for that? I'll give you the bag for mine.
You don't want to check that?
You're going to pay me back, aren't you?
Of course.
Cross your heart and hope to die. I think we understand each other. Mm-hmm. Sharon, you're not forgetting something. I knew you weren't the type to take candy for your baby.
I'm back. Scott? You awake?
You are definitely up to something.
Yep.
What is it?
I'm not telling.
What have you got there?
You'll find out soon enough.
I can make you tell me.
Well, you could try. But remember, I fight dirty. Now you disappear before I make you cry like a little girl. Try that. That's why they call it punch.
Some job you did it there.
Yeah, well, Scarlett wanted a classy look.
I'm really going to miss you.
There were a couple of times I actually wanted to kill you. I lay awake at night planning it. But even at the worst times, you know, when I really hated you, I could never imagine this place without you.
You didn't really...
Yeah, but it all worked out.
Of
Go on then.
No, I'll keep it to myself. Might come in handy one day. So how's your fiancé?
Last minute packing. I think she's got me a wee surprise.
Bless.
I really wish you guys had got to know each other better. Maybe bonded a little bit.
Yeah, bummer that.
Well, anyway, I've got something for you.
Yeah? Oh, where did you get these?
The attic. We were always saying we should sort them out.
Oh, you look at us. When did you find the time?
I didn't. Sharon did.
No, you can't give me this. Was she not mine?
It was her idea.
Are you all done?
Yeah. We fill up as good as gold.
Great.
Well, well, eh? You would have thought. How you doing? All right?
What do you think?
Look, maybe this is a good thing, eh? Keep your mind off other things.
Having a grandchild is hardly what I want right now. Have you found him?
No, not yet.
Have you found anything? Have you even tried?
Of course I've tried. It was a long time ago, Lydia.
Great. So, in the meantime, I've got to smile sweetly as Ewan and Joe walk into the biggest mistake of their life.
That's no fair.
Oh, come on, Lenny. It's hardly a match made in heaven.
Look, Lydia. I'm sorry I haven't found the boy yet. But I'm not sorry that Ewan is having a kid.
Well, I'm not sure that he sees things the same way.
Well, we'll just have to be there, help him and Joe through. You make it work.
It's not fair.
Darling, I know it's not.
You haven't seen Raymond, have you?
He's just nipped to the shops.
Sun cream.
What?
I said to him we would buy it when we got there.
No way.
It's a 30-second walk from the airport to the taxi. Can't take the risk.
It's Celtic complexion.
That's right, that's exactly what he said.
The time we went to Greece, he was a bottle a day. He was stalking round town like the abominable snowman.
That's it.
Sure, I think it's Av. Fully committed to your card is. Jacket clocks. Hey, give me the 50p. Oh. Come on, we had a deal. What? The boy's a crook.
Can
you not think about it? Let's see if we can get Ewan away, eh? Is he still on the phone? Ewan, your presence is required.
Hang on. Listen, can I call you back?
Ewan Murdoch, would you mind getting off the phone?
Thanks.
thought you might like to join us in a game of cards.
This is what you got me off the phone for. What?
Nothing. It's just... Well, it's kind of weird, isn't it? Do you want the kids moving in like this?
They're not moving in. It's just a little visit, that's all.
Still, I think it's sweet.
Really?
A few weeks ago, you were young, free and single. Now, you've got this whole new family. It's like the sound of music.
I don't think so.
Worth finding out, though, eh? The little ones, Romeo and... What's his name? Maybe they can sing. Oh, and one more thing, Ewan. I don't know if you've seen one of these before.
Hi, sorry to bother you. I'm trying to get in touch with Marty Green. Yeah, that's right. I'm interested in some property and I've lost his details.
Yeah.
Well, do you know anyone who might... Okay, thank you.
I'm going to take you out for dinner.
The wine list.
He doesn't have a clue.
Now, the Shiraz, do you store it upright or horizontal? I'm sitting there gagging for a drink and he sends it back because it's corked. It was a flipping screw top.
See, that's what I love about Raymond. His total inability to look after himself.
I'd be happy to Peru right now in a donkey if it wasn't for you looking after him.
What's going on here?
We're swapping Raymond stories. I thought you'd be pleased. They're bonding.
Yeah. That's right. I just need an address. You do? Yeah? Yeah? No. No, that's his old address. Yeah, no, he moved. Yeah. Well, listen, thanks anyway. Ready? And that's definitely him. And do you have a postcode for that? Oh, it doesn't matter. Yeah, no. Listen, that's brilliant. Yeah, thanks a million.
Anybody here?
Actually, I've got something for you. It's nothing much, just a token of my affection.
Shona, you really shouldn't have.
But I wanted to.
This is your doing, isn't it?
You had that other pair the first time we went on holiday, and they were falling to bits then. Hey, these are all the rage. Everyone in Spain's wearing them.
She's right. You're going to fit right in.
Literally.
Whiskey, please.
Karaoke's kicking off in 5 minutes. Just get your name at the bar.
It's a losing battle.
Sorry?
We're a nice, quiet pub to enjoy your misery.
do they give you?
Fairy donkeys, I will say.
Do you fancy another?
Probably don't get cheerful on me. Same again.
Fish supples. Is that all you're going to miss?
Oh, aye, right enough. Don't you've got square sausage over there either?
What about us? What about your mates?
Maybe it's a wee bit.
A bunch.
He's all talk.
Oh, you think so?
I know you, Raymond Henderson. You go on the blower every 5 minutes.
No danger. I'll be too busy lying on the beach, sipping sangrias and watching the lovely senoritas go by.
Aye, and Sharon will belt you with a pile of pan if she catches you.
Oh, you wouldn't do that to me, darling, would you?
What's that?
Hit me with a saucepan for ogling senoritas.
Of course you wouldn't. You get better impact with a baseball bat.
The dick you got, Matt.
Quiet, please. A bit of hush, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Maybe later, eh?
Tonight, and for one night only, the tall ship proudly presents, for your delectation and delight, the Ex-Wives Club!
You have no way!
Come on. I'll tell you again.
Woo. Why do birds sing so gay? And lovers await the break of day. Why do they fall in love?
Absolutely right. I mean, when we were kids, we were more or less the same age, right? When we were kids, your mum was your mum and your dad was your dad.
Damn right.
And that's the way it was. But in my grandfather's day,
different world.
The old boy had 3-4 kids. And I know for a fact that he celebrated every single birth with a marathon booze up from the minute the old dear went into labour till the minute she came back with the kid. Washed, fed, fast asleep.
What's wrong with that?
Everyone's happy. Tell you what, it was even better for gay blokes, though.
How so?
Well, the unlucky ones got nicked, yeah? The really unlucky ones got married. But for everyone else, as long as they kept quiet, they could live a totally child-free existence.
You're right.
But now, though...
Oh,
they all want kids. All of them. I was watching a programme on the telly. Huh? There's not a gay man left in Britain that thinks life's worth living unless he's got some sticky brat putting his dirty finger marks all over his Scissor Sisters collection.
Yeah, you're right.
I mean, what's all that about?
Mate, I don't know.
Crazy.
Absolutely crazy.
There you are.
Oh, hiya.
What's going on?
No, I just stay. I just fancied a bit of peace and quiet, you know, all the singing.
Is that right?
Anyway, I best be getting back, eh?
No, you don't.
I don't want to seem antisocial.
You stay where you are. Now, let's get back to my original question. What's going on?
Nothing. What's the big deal?
What's the big deal? Well, I leave in about half an hour for a new home, new country, and I kind of thought you might want to have a wee chat with me so that you could wish me good luck and all the best.
I will. Good luck. All the best.
All right. Fine.
Hey, why do you have to go anyway? Hey? I mean, you've got a job here, a home, family. Why do you want to give all that up?
I don't want to give it up. It's not about that.
What is it about then?
I'm not exactly the luckiest guy in the world when it comes to love, am I? But Sharon, she's turned all that around for me. She gets me, Deke. She gets what I'm all about. And that's important. She wants to give it a go. Try it. New life. New country.
She thinks it'll be good for us. See, if it was up to me, I'd quite happily sit on Mars right here, but that's not a good thing. You got to try things, Deke. You got to take a few risks once in a while. Now, she's asked me to take a risk, and I've said yes, because she means a lot to me. Because I love her.
Well, good luck, right? And all the best. I mean that. Right.
Come here, you.
Oh, sorry.
He's really going to miss you. A lot of people are.
I'm really going to miss them.
I feel rotten, dragging you away for all this.
Hey, don't you worry. There's no dragon involved.
See how everybody loves you. Maybe moving to Spain isn't the right thing after all.
Listen, these guys mean a lot to me. You mean a hell of a lot more. And anyway, I could have them over to visit.
You bet.
Then they toss bits of bread and cake crumbs into the water, and they all agreed that the new one was the handsomest of all. So he ruffled his feathers and he held his neck up high. And he was happy now. Happier than he'd ever been before, because he wasn't an ugly duckling anymore. He was a beautiful white swan. There, did you enjoy that?
I liked it too.
Oh, I didn't realise you were there.
Well, I didn't want to interrupt. You're very good with them.
They're lovely boys.
Yeah, well, you're getting to see them on a good day. Normally it's scabby knees, runny noses and tantrums.
Well, I kind of like that. They grow up so fast. Anyway, I better get them some sandwiches. They must be starving.
Oh no, we should be getting out of your hair.
Don't worry about it.
Oh, at least let me make them.
Okay.
Lydia, I'm really glad you're the granny.
Nervous? Grab that with your life. That's a taxi. Alright, let's go.
You're not going to miss this weather, are you?
You buying?
I think I'm going to cry.
Oh, don't be daft.
Mother?
I thought I made myself clear.
It's all tens and twenties, I'm afraid, so it's a fiver over, but hey, just call it interest.
Where did you get this?
Oh, I do have a few friends left, apparently. You know, the kind of folk that'll help you out when you need help. Even if it's not all that convenient. Goodbye, Mother.
I don't hate kids.
Of course not.
I used to be one.
That's right.
It doesn't mean I want them running my life, though. It's nature, isn't it? Yeah. Like cavemen. Women's at home changing the nappies, man's out hunting dinosaurs. Gay blokes too.
Absolutely.
I had a couple of guys in my platoon. Didn't advertise it.
No.
Cold-blooded kids.
I bet they were.
Absolute psychos.
Yep.
Cavemen.
you. Are you all right? Yeah? Fine.
I don't suppose he's cold.
You know what he's like. Come on, come sit down. Someday, eh? I think it's been a bit of a shock for all of us. And it can be easy for you. Two little ones and another on the way. But you know, we're here for you. Do you want me to ring him?
I've already tried. Switched his phone off.
Oh, is that right?
Oh, 2 hour delay. What a joke, eh?
That just means we can get tucked into our leaving goodies then. Eh? We've got time to kill, we might as well enjoy ourselves.
What do you want?
Oh, I'm sorry, is it boys only? Joe's at home doing your best not to burst into tears, do you know that?
Obviously not.
Well, you do now. So maybe it's time you came home and apologised to her.
Apologise for what?
Don't play dumb with me. Well?
I'm not going to jump for any woman. Not you, and certainly not her.
Well, maybe you should do it because it's the right thing to do. I'm sure your friend will understand.
You gotta go. You gotta go.
Good luck, Raymond and Sharon, and always remember, love doesn't make the world go round, but it makes the ride worthwhile. Malcolm.
That's lovely.
Oh, the very best of luck to both of you. May the road rise up to meet your feet and the wind be at your back. Love, Liz.
That's nice.
Oh, what's that? I'll see your face while I am dreaming. That's why I always wake up screaming.
Dick.
Who else? Hang on. Here we go.
All right, I might just nip to the loo.
Well, don't be too long. I need to pay a quick visit myself.
Well, no, will you go first then?
Don't be daft.
On you go. Honestly, I've got some serious makeup to do here.
Suit yourself. Love you.
Beat it, you.
Congratulations, Marty. It's a girl.
Raymond. Come back, man. How can you leave me to look after this nutter?
Statuettes are standing stately in the hall, but will time round and laughing loud help you dry your tears?
Wasn't my idea.
What wasn't?
To get you to come back.
Yeah, well, Lydia was worried.
Well, I just get a bit teary, that's all. It's perfectly natural.
You really should tell Gina.
Why?
That's what mums are for.
Oh, really? Then what are you for?
Well, I'm here, aren't I?
Well, don't trouble yourself on my account.
Look, I just think you should tell her. She's your mother, she'd want to know.
You don't know what she's like. As soon as she hears there's a kid in the way, she'll be fussing around me like a hen with a caffeine habit.
Right. Because the one thing you don't like is people making a fuss.
I can't believe you just said that.
Believe me, if you weren't pregnant, I'd say a lot more.
You're a pig. Do you know that? A complete and utter pig.
That went well.
Nearly the elephant back to trunk and said goodbye to the circus. Off she went with a trumpety trump, 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 trump. Nearly the elephant back to trunk and trundled off to the... Hey there, we wondered where you'd got to.
Yeah, I just nipped down.
Sorry, I fell asleep.
No worries.
Thought I might go for a walk later, see if I'll get this one off.
Sure.
See, I told you he'd come. She thought her Uncle Manu might be a wee bit grumpy, but I knew better, didn't I? Yes, I did.
What's going on?
How do you mean?
You and Joe. What's the problem?
She's at it.
She's pregnant.
So what? You see what she's trying to do, don't you? She's muscling in. She sees a happy family and thinks, yeah, I want a piece of that.
Listen, even if you're right, okay? Still your baby she's carrying. You look after her, you look after that.
Oh, so it's a boy now, is it?
I don't know, maybe. Look, when a man has a child, right? Everything changes, your whole world changes. You can't go around behaving like you used to.
Oh, so when I was born, your whole world changed, did it? Took me to work with you, played footy with me in the street.
It was different back then. We didn't realise how important these things were.
Oh, how very convenient.
Okay, I made mistakes, but you don't need to make them. Nothing is more important than being a father, Ewan.
I know that. Look, I'm 27 years old. I mean, sure, I want kids someday, but right now...
You don't always get a choice.
Not when you have a kid, no. But you normally get to pick who you have a kid with.
People think I'm a monster.
Hi, this is Sharon. Leave me a message.
Sharon, it's me. Where are you? Is there something wrong? Call me.
Right, keep an eye on the wee one for me, would you?
Sure.
Why can't I watch your cartoons? This is rubbish. Got any sweeties?
Shh.
What you got there?
Sean! 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 Sean, where are you? God, I'm really sorry, it's my mistake.
Yes, yeah, of course I will.
somebody new. Crazy for thinking that my love could hold you. I'm crazy for trying and crazy for crying, and I'm crazy for loving you. Crazy for thinking that my love could hold you. I'm crazy for trying and crazy for crying, and I'm crazy for loving you.
You know how much I wanted a child, and you know what it cost me to have an abortion.
What's this family like, eh? Lurching from one crisis to the next.
I'm not sure feeling sorry for yourself is going to help.
Do you know this one's pregnant again?
Oh, Joanne.
Well, usually folks say congratulations.
You shouldn't be back here at all. You don't get another chance.
You can't have her. She's not yours.
Yes, she is.
You're a liar.
No. Stay back.
I said stay back!
And we're back in Shieldinch next Sunday at the same time, at 1:15. Meanwhile, Susie's back in the square, and in for a shock is the EastEnders Omnibus next on BBC One Scotland.